Whale Rider is a 2002 New Zealand film directed by Nikki Caro, based on the novel of the same name by Witi Umaira. The film tells the story of a young girl named Pai, who is the only living heir to chiefdom in the Maori community of Whangara. In every generation for over 1,000 years, only a male heir is selected to succeed the title of chiefdom. However, Pai's twin brother died during childbirth, leaving the ancient customs upset. Pai's grandfather, Koro, refuses to accept her as a potential leader, and she must achieve the impossible by winning him over.
You knew this wasn't for you.
I'm sorry, Paka.
You don't mess around with sacred things!
Why doesn't he want me?
He's just looking for something that doesn't exist anymore.
A new leader. They exist.
The themes of tradition, ancestry, and determination are seen through strong symbolism throughout the film. It is also an accurate representation of Maori traditions and culture. While writing the book The Whale Rider, Witi Umaira drew on his own experiences growing up as Maori in the small town of Waitui, New Zealand, and sought to give voice to the stories and perspectives of his people through his writing. He finished the book in 1987, during a strong push towards the creation of opportunities for Maori in government, commerce, bureaucracy, arts, and culture. He said in an interview that Whale Rider was part of that manifestation, in order to create myths for the future, because the book is based on and recreates older myths from the past. At the time of writing the book, Umaira was hoping for it to manifest the beginning of the journey of Maori people negotiating themselves into modern society. He also wrote the modern retelling of a Maori legend in response to his daughter's observation that the heroes in stories are, more often than not, male. Nikki Caro, the director behind the Whale Rider movie, is a New Zealander not of Maori descent but had the full support of the Maori community behind her during the making of the film. She began by learning the language, then approached them for permission and expressed gratitude for the privilege to tell the story. Umaira had some reservations when Caro joined the project, but in the end was thrilled at the work, stating that the greatest seal of authenticity is that the film was claimed by the Maori as their own. An important symbol in the film is the Reputa, a whale tooth necklace that is passed down through the generations of the tribe's leaders. As part of his sacred school of learning for the firstborn boys of Pai's generation, Koro takes the boys out in a boat, barring Pai from participating. After tossing the necklace into the ocean, he then orders the boys to retrieve it, declaring that the first to surface with the necklace is fit to become chief of the village. None of them manage it, leading Koro to become depressed and hopeless. Later in the film, on a boat trip with her uncle, Pai dives underwater to retrieve Koro's reputa from the bottom of the ocean.
It's just over there.
I'll get it.
She not only retrieves it, but also brings up a lobster for Koro's dinner. When her uncle returns the necklace to Pai's grandmother, however, she replies that Koro is not ready yet to face the truth about Pai. The Reputa is a very significant representation of ancestry and leadership, and when Pai's grandfather Koro refuses to give it to her, it emphasizes his belief that she is not fit to lead the village. It is also a symbol of Koro's traditional ways, as he is always wearing the necklace and only takes it off when attempting to find the next chief. This necklace links Koro to the origins of his people because it has been worn by every chief in the past, another tradition that he proudly upholds. When Pai manages to not only retrieve it from the water but also catch food, she shows her ability to meet the challenge and provide. Another important symbol, the whale, is used as a powerful representation of the connection between the Maori people and their ancestral land. The people's history and culture is closely tied to the whales because legend goes that their first ancestor, Paikia, escaped death on the back of a whale to reach their homeland. The whale is a symbol of tradition, heritage, and connection to the past. In the later part of the film, Pai calls out to the whales and they listen, beaching themselves on the shore. Koro orders Pai not to touch the whales as they are scared and hold the power of their ancestor, but the whales soon begin dying, and Pai decides to go against his orders and help. She climbs on top of the bull whale and it responds to her. Carrying them both back out to sea while the other whales follow. This demonstrates to us her inherited leadership power as she takes her ancestor Paikia's place atop the whales. It also represents the village's traditions changing, with Pai bringing forth a new future to customs rooted in the past. After swimming with the whales, Pai is found on the shore and hospitalized. This is when Koro finally understands that she is meant to be the next chief, as he declares her the leader and asks for forgiveness. Overall, Whale Rider uses powerful symbols and motifs to convey the themes of tradition, heritage, and connection to the past. The film explores the idea of cultural identity, and the powerful imagery of the whales and the Reiputa serve to underscore these themes. Eventually, Pai manages to convince Koro of her worthiness to be chief, and claims her rightful place as leader of the village. In order to stay respectful of Maori culture and protocols, I used the correct spelling of words in Te Reo Maori and avoided transliteration. I also watched language introductory videos to correct my pronunciation. Thank you for watching this documentary.